bow down prostrate. You are the only one worthy of praise. مجموعة الفتاوى by حافظ ابن تيمية رحمه الله. You are following Hanafi school, you are following Deen of Islam. If you are following Maliki school, you are following Deen of Islam. The thought provoking question is, the Hafiz ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, who passed away in 728 Hijri, he has mentioned the four schools of thought. He hasn't mentioned the pseudo Salafis or the so called Ahlul Hadith. Why? Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. My dear respected brothers and elders, honorable listeners, today I would like to give a clear message to those Salafi and so-called Ahlul Hadith brothers who have a problem and who condemn following only one school of thought. And this message I would like to give to them by quoting Hafiz ibn Taymiyyah rahmatullahi alayh. What is Hafiz ibn Taymiyyah rahmatullahi alayh's opinion regarding the four schools and the Hanafi school of thought? This I have in front of me. Majmu'atul Fatawa by Hafiz ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, volume 14. Volume 14. In volume 14, page 263, Hafiz ibn Taymiyyah mentions, وَمَعْلُومْ أَنَّ أَهْلَ الْمَذَاهِبِ كَالْحَنَفِيَّةِ وَالْمَالِكِيَّةِ وَالشَّافِعِيَّةِ وَالْحَنْبَلِيَّةِ دِينُهُمْ وَاحِدٌ. That it is known that the followers of the schools, the followers of the madhahib, the people of the madhahib, Ahlul Madhahib, like Hanafiyya, Malikiyya, Shafi'iyya, Hanbaliyya, deenuhum wahid, their deen is one. I.e. in other words, all of those people who adhere and who follow or who attribute themselves towards one of the four schools, Hanafi school, Maliki school, Shafi'i school, Hanbali school, all of their deen is one, i.e. deen of Islam. So if you are following Hanafi school, you are following deen of Islam. If you are following Maliki school, you are following deen of Islam. If you are following Shafi'i school, you are following deen of Islam. If you are following Hanbali school, you are following deen of Islam. Who is saying this? In other words, Hafiz ibn Taymiyyah. Hafiz ibn Taymiyyah rahmatullah alayhi is saying that these four schools, their deen is one. And then he says, وَكُلُّ مَنْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ مِنْهُمْ بِحَسْبِ وُسْعِهِ كَانَ مُؤْمِنًا سَعِيدًا بِاتِّفَاقِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. That whomsoever from amongst them, from amongst the followers of the Hanafiyya, Malikiyya, Shafi'iyya, Hanbaliyya, obeys Allah and His Rasul بِحَسْبِ وُسْعِهِ, according to his capacity, according to his ability, then he is a fortunate believer. He is a fortunate believer. Yani, he is a successful believer. He is a fortunate believer. بِاتِّفَاقِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ, with the agreement and the consensus of the believers. With the agreement and the consensus of the Muslims, this person from the four schools of thought who obeys Allah and His Rasul is a fortunate believer. مُؤْمِن سَعِيد. He is a successful believer. And this Hafiz ibn Taymiyyah rahmatullahi alayhi has mentioned inside Majmu'atul Fatawa, page 263. ومعلوم أن أهل المذاهب كالحنفية والمالكية والشافعية والحنبلية دينهم واحد. All of their deen is one. وكل من أطاع الله ورسوله منهم بحسب وسعه كان مؤمنا سعيدا باتفاق المسلمين. Now I have a thought-provoking question. The thought-provoking question is, the Hafiz ibn Taymiyyah رحمه الله, who passed away in 728 Hijri, he has mentioned the four schools of thought. He hasn't mentioned the pseudo Salafis or the so-called Ahlul Hadith. Why? This is the question. Allahu alam what the answer is, because we cannot ask Hafiz ibn Taymiyyah as he's passed away. But one thing is for sure, that these two groups never existed at the time. This is for sure, that the group of Ahlul Hadith and pseudo so-called Salafis didn't exist at the time of Hafiz Ibn Taymiyyah rahmatullahi alayh. They were not recognized at that time. They're the Ahlul Bid'ah and the people innovators of today. So according to Hafiz Ibn Taymiyyah, the four schools and their followers, their deen is one. So in other words, if you are following one school, any of the four schools, you are following deen. You are following deen. And inshallah ta'ala, you will be a successful believer with the consensus and the agreement of the Muslims. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all the tawfiq to adhere to one school of thought. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all from the ways of shaitan. Wa akhiru da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
محمد رسول الله محمد رسول الله أرجو رضاك يا الله أنت الرحيم يا الله.